I am Slick Nick, your personal keto bro. And no, I'm not a doctor, a dietitian, a nutritionist, or a personal trainer. I'm just some random 40-year-old man on the internet who has embraced a change that has allowed me to go from dad bod to now someone who is officially fit, which is harder to do as you get older. And I want to point this out because to me this is just common knowledge, common sense. But I don't drink my calories. I drink about a gallon of water throughout the day, every day. That's very important to me. But as far as drinking juice, I don't drink juice. It's funny, like V8, for example, I'm thinking of the 1982 movie E.T. I woke up thinking about this today. That's why I'm making this video. The mom on E.T. is made mention that she is into health food. Her son makes mention of that when he opens up the fridge, the older son, and he complains that it's all healthy food. Well, you see V8 in there. And there's another time in the cabinet she opens up and you see V8, which is funny to me because common knowledge to me, that's not healthy. V8, so drinking tomato juice with vitamins. Like, if you want to eat healthy food and get nutrients that you need, you eat the thing in its entirety. So eat the tomato, eat the carrot, but don't drink it because you're stripping away the fiber from that. So it's ultimately empty calories that count against you that are going to cause you to ultimately store more body fat if you go over your calories for the day. Or that could be just what it would take to lose extra body fat if you didn't consume it. Because however many calories that is, you could do better by eating the real thing. If you actually ate the real thing, it'd hardly be any calories. And then you could replace those calories with fat or protein, things that would keep you from feeling hungry, and things that could actually help you maintain your muscle mass as you are losing fat. But even if you were just trying to maintain your body weight, that's just not a good way to do it, drinking V8 or drinking juice. People are like, oh, it's healthy, it's natural. Yeah, but so is the actual thing that before it was juiced, because ultimately juicing something is processed. And of course, some people will mess up when it comes to like coffee, for example. You know, for me, I'm keto, so I just put pure fat in there, whether it's butter or heavy cream or MCT oil. And those calories do count against me, but they also allow me not to be as hungry so that I can push my eating window out later in the day and ultimately have two meals and eat less calories overall. It's a little, taking one for the team a little bit. It's an insurance policy against consuming too many calories. So you could say that my coffee has a lot of calories in it, but it's not empty calories. They're calories that I need. I need fat and I need protein, but sugar, just putting in, because for example, I guess the average vanilla latte from Starbucks or whatever is gonna have roughly 30 grams of sugar in it, carbohydrates in it. Whereas for me, that's about how many carbs I eat in an average day, whether it's two slices of Dave's, you know, killer bread, or whether it's a half a cup of unsweetened oats. And granted, I also eat some cherries, berries, blueberries, etc., but not a whole lot, and there's not a whole lot of sugar. Those are actually tart more than anything. So still, worst case scenario, maybe 40, 50 carbs a day, but in just one drink. And people start out their day with drinking something like that, which only spikes their insulin, which only triggers ghrelin, which makes you hungrier. So it's just a horrible way to do things, to start your day with juice or V8 or a coffee drink with sugar in it. So for me, that's common knowledge, but a lot of people who are not actively pursuing weight loss or specifically fat loss and muscle gain don't realize that. And I never even really thought about this until college. There was like a healthier professor who talked about this. There was some girls in the front row that had Starbucks Frappuccinos, and he's like, okay, you can eat your calories and you can also drink them. They still count against you either way. So I think that's interesting, and maybe people don't talk about it or realize it enough. But yeah, when I drink a lot of calories in my coffee, but they're not empty calories. So that's what it comes down to. I don't drink empty calories. I drink calories, but I don't drink empty ones. It's pretty much pure fat in coffee, or it's water. That's pretty much what I'm having to drink. When it comes to alcohol, there's Budweiser Select 55, which has like two carbs in it, 55 calories. So there's also just like gin or whiskey that are straight, where it hardly has any carbohydrates. But other than that, even alcohol, I pretty much stay away from. Even red wine, I stay away from, because I realize there's still calories in that, especially alcohol. Technically, it's empty calories. So I consider all of that. So ultimately, water and coffee with pure fat, that's what I'm drinking, but I'm not going to drink empty calories. And obviously not soda. I didn't even bring that up. Same thing with diet soda, bunch of chemicals. I'm doing my best to stay away from preservatives, chemicals, artificial sweeteners, all that good stuff. Being keto, that's very important to me. All right, now's your turn to go ahead and leave a comment right here.